Welcome to another great edition today, guys. Today is Video Day. So I uploaded a couple videos today. This is the third video on Brian's channel. So I'm sitting around today doing some work, and I thought about another video to put up there on the Brian's channel. Guys, I want to talk to you a little bit about, we did racism a while ago. We did Irma, the deal about that. This video, guys, I already got the dip in the lip already. So we're going to move right on along into this video. Now, this video is about blacks and whites and Mexicans, or people in general, marrying, let's just say, out of their color. Okay? Now, that being said, a lot of people have a problem with black people getting with white folks. Okay? And I see it on Facebook. I see it on certain pages on Facebook. Guys, knock that shit off. I really don't want to hear it. Okay? Let me go ahead and say I do not want to hear it. Now, I'm going to tell you exactly the way I see it. Okay? The problem is the way folks is raised. Okay, so now I was raised that you marry inside of your color. Okay, you marry inside of your color. Now, that being said, this country has turned a different page in the books. Started changing in 2000, I'll say 13, 14. It took a change. You got lesbians marrying lesbians. You got gay, gays marrying gays. You know, you got, you know, different things had changed in the way my daddy was raised and his daddy was raised. Now, I'm going to tell you, the problem is a lot of folks raise their kids and tell you, because I was raised that way, you marry inside your race, that's it. And I'm going to tell you, this country does not follow that rule no more. My point of view is that it don't matter who you marry. You marry a Mexican, you can marry a Cuban, you can marry a black, whatever color you want to marry, okay? Marry them. Now, I mean, I'm not telling you not to. Well, my point of view is y'all need to be respectful to the people that are married to blacks, you know, different race. You know, they love each other. That if a person loves each other that daggone much, don't you think that they should be happy with the person they marry? You know, didn't you were happy when you got married to your husband, your wife, when you got married? You know, where they deserve to be happy as well, without the judgment upon them. Okay? Because we're all equal, like the last video I mentioned. We're all equal. You know, I really and truly, my nephew can come to me and say, "Uncle, I'm in love with this black chick. She, me and her love each other, blah, blah, blah. We got good vibes, da, 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 da." You know what I'm going to tell him? "Son, do whatever makes you happy. It is your life. Live your life." That's what some people need to do. Now, the problem is these kids that they have gets dogged because of their color, their mom and daddy's, you know, different colors. y'all need to knock that off. Y'all need to tell your kids, you know what? So what, son? Their family's different than what we have here. You need to knock it off and go on with their lives. Let them be happy. Quit judging everybody by the way, the color of their skin. Okay? Or the family that has, you know, black and white together. Or Cuban and white. Y'all need to stop letting that affect your life and stop worrying about what everybody else is doing. Let them be happy. Let them enjoy their lives. And if they have a baby, you know, y'all got to accept that. The problem is there's too much bullying going around these schools, and the kids think it's okay to dog them because why? The parents are sitting there dogging about it. And then y'all need to knock it off, grow up, let it thing go, let the families be happy. Because, you know, my sister and brother-in-law, they're getting married. And one day they're going to have a kid of their own. And whether it's black, blue, green, whatever, my nephew, niece will be loved no matter what by his uncle. I will be there for my nephew and niece like I always have tried to be with all my niece and nephew. Sometimes I'm not able to do that because of work, but that's understandable. Y'all need to accept that, move on, let them enjoy their lives instead of judging them because of a relationship they're in. You know, it's just like gays and lesbians. Most people judge them because two girls got married or two guys got married, blah, blah, blah. You know, y'all need to knock that off. Judgment is not for you guys. Judgment is for God himself. God is the only one that can judge a person in and out. He's the only one that can tell whether or not you're going to go into heaven or you're going to hell. And that's just that. Guys, you got to leave the color, all that shit behind. I'm tired of listening to shit like that. I mean, I posted on racism. That was a big subject. I'm posting on now blacks and whites or Mexicans, Cubans, all interrace stuff. You need to leave that alone. Because, you know, a lot of people take that seriously to heart. You know, you go over there and tell a black man, this way the white girl talk about, you know, blah, 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 blah. What's going to happen? He's going to get upset. Then y'all two going to fight. It's not a good place to be. Y'all need to knock it off, let that go on, and teach your kids not to be bullying these kids around at school. You know, that's where it starts with you guys. If you guys teach your kids not to bully other kids, maybe their kids will grow up the way I did and not be any racism to not judge because a black person's with a white chick. You know, that's just not right. You know what I'm saying? To be judgmental. And what I find by talking to a lot of different people, black men choose white girls because of A, they're lovable, they're this, they're that. White or black chicks choose white dudes for simple reasons as well. That's just the type of person that they are. Hispanics the same damn way. You know, it's just not just blacks and whites, guys. People choose different races for different reasons. You need to let that go and not sit there and call people out because they're married to a different race. You need to let that go. You need to go on about your business because you don't need to do it. Because you're hurting the people that need to be happy. If you're happy about your life, then you need to let them be happy. It's pointed, point blank. You need to let them be happy. Now, as far as bullying, guys, it's not going to cause anything but people to get hurt. Y'all, just grow the hell up. That's all I'm saying. Grow the hell up. Let it go. Let bygones be bygones. If you don't like to do, tell them you don't like to do it and move the freak on. Shoutouts. As always, check out Pissed Off Redneck. Check out Hillbilly and the Wife. Also, too, check out my boy Imagine Man. Check out Crazy Joe. And check out Chris. What's his? Twisted Chris 96. Guys, go check him out. And also, too, go check out Dad Ass and Melissa MC, guys. Go check them out on YouTube. Let them know that Brian sent you over there to check them out. Also, to get the, when you subscribe to the Hillbilly and the Wife and Pissed Off Redneck, make sure you get your code for RedneckNationGear.com, guys. Get y'all your free Redneck gear. Get some hats, some shirts. With RedneckGear.com, guys, you can't use a debit card. I forgot to mention in my last couple videos, you cannot use a debit card, guys. You must have a PayPal account. So, just to let you know a little tidbit that I left out. But go get your code for Hillbilly and the Wife and Pissed Off Redneck to get your gears, guys, so you can save that money and look redneck fine, looking good. See what else. Also, too, guys, don't forget to email the Brian's channel at brian.naught1@aol.com. Also, too, don't forget to check us out on Facebook page, Brian Naught. And also, check that I've got some cool groups on there, guys. You know, that y'all can take a part of. Get on there and get over there and check us out on these groups, guys, on the Brian's channel. Also, too, guys, I have a Snapchat. If I can find it. Hold on a second. I'm fixing to give you my Snapchat. Let's see. I am on Snapchat. Just look for Brian Naught. Type that in the search engine. Send me an ad, and I will get you on there on Snapchat. So y'all can Snapchat me anytime. I'll check them and get back to you guys, and I will add you on Snapchat. But guys, please go check us out on Facebook, Twitter. Just look for Brian, type in Brian, and it should pull up Brian. No, if it don't, just if you got Facebook, send me a message on Matt, M-A-T-T, Naught, N-E-U-L-T, and I will get you added on Instagram. Guys, also, too, go check out Pissed Off Redneck on Instagram. Go check out Hillbilly and the Wife on Instagram, guys. So we are on there. So guys, go check us out on our pages, guys. And as always, from Brian's channel, we love you. God bless you, guys. I'm sending the prayers down to you guys in Florida. I hope that every y'all get y'all's power back and get things dried up, cleaned up, and looking good, back to normal. Guys, stay classy. Stay redneck. Stay true to what you believe in. And as always, here at Brian's channel, I will see you on the countryside.